Now, I've said a word about virtue. I want to now say a word, if I may, about science. And the reason I do it is that in every generation, new questions arise. A generation ago, a little more than that, when C.S. Lewis was writing in the aftermath of World War II, he was addressing questions that came out of the war. Why would a just God allow the Holocaust? Questions like that. Today's questions are a little different. The new atheism marches behind the banner of science. And its argument is that science is simply a better way of knowing than religion. Science is based on reason, and Christianity is based on faith. What the atheists call blind faith, what the Bible calls the evidence of things not seen. So the atheist view is science is simply a more reliable, more workable way of finding out stuff. People trust their lives to science every time they step on an airplane. Faith is another word for irrationality. And the argument the atheists make is they say science seems to be inexorably advancing, and Christianity is in unceasing and humiliating retreat. Why is this? Because from ancient times, when man could not explain stuff, he attributed it to God. Ancient man looked out of his cave, he saw a bolt of lightning. Hey, where'd that come from? That must have been the lightning god. I hear a clap of thunder. Where'd that come from? That must have been the thunder god. But then science explains this stuff. Today we know lightning is an electrical discharge. You don't need to posit God to explain lightning. God has got to find for himself other things to do. Science moves forward. Christianity backs off. And this story, which is told so eloquently, it's made its way into textbooks. A lot of Christians even believe it. That the medieval Christians for many, many centuries believed the earth is flat until the brilliant scientists showed up to show that no, with their instruments, and that it's round. Embarrassing 1,000 years of Christian hocus pocus. And then the Christians believe that the earth is the center of the universe. Sun goes around the earth. But then first Copernicus, then Galileo showed up and revealed, no, it's the other way around. The earth goes around the sun. And then later, the Christians believed that God made every separate creature, each unto its kind, until Darwin, the patron saint of modern atheism, emerged to show that chance and natural selection can fully account for the diversity of the species. You don't need to posit a creator. So there is the narrative that we're all exposed to. And I want to spend a moment just kind of looking at it. First of all, I want to look at the details, because this idea of science advancing and Christianity retreating, it relies on about 3 specific cases. The flat earth, Galileo, Darwin. That's the tripod. If those 3 legs of the tripod fall, the whole argument collapses. And I think when you begin to look at those legs, you realize that they are actually a little bit shaky. Consider the idea of the flat earth. If you do a little bit of historical research, you'll discover that educated people throughout the Middle Ages knew perfectly well that the earth is round. In fact, educated people at the time of Christ knew that the earth is round. In fact, the ancient Greeks who lived 500 years before Christ knew that the earth is round. And how did they know? Well, it turns out you don't need Galileo's telescope to figure it out. All you have to do is watch an eclipse. Here's the sun. Here's the earth. Here's the moon. You can see the shadow of the earth on the moon. Hey, fellas, it's round. Aristotle knew that the earth is round. So the notion of the flat earth turns out to be a complete myth. But let's probe a little bit further and ask if it is actually true that science is based on reason and Christianity based on faith. It's normal in Christian apologetics to dispute this by trying to prove that Christianity also is based on reason. I'm actually going the other way. I want to show you very briefly that science is actually based on faith. Am I talking about science 300 years ago in the time of Newton? No. I'm actually speaking of science right now. Science is actually based on three faith-based propositions that can in no way be demonstrated by evidence and are, in fact, directly lifted from Christian theology. What are those three faith-based propositions of modern science? Number one, we live in a rational universe. Now, if you think about it, this is actually a very hard thing to prove. You or I can be rational. We have a brain. But why should the universe be rational? Modern science is kind of based on the assumption that it is. Well, consider a second idea, that the universe is not just rational, which is to say intelligible, but it is also lawful, that the operations of the objects in the universe, you might say, conform to the lawful language of mathematics and some fairly exotic mathematical rules, Kepler's laws of planetary rotation, Newton's inverse square law, Einstein's E equals mc square. You only have to go to other cultures to see how odd this is. Now, the Muslim thinker Al-Ghazali says, you or I can follow a law. That's because we are intentional, purposeful agents. We're walking on a street. Hypothetically, we see a stop sign, we stop. We can follow laws. How can inanimate objects follow rules? Al-Ghazali says, it's ridiculous. He says, the universe must exist in the mind of Allah. Everything that happens, happens because Allah wills it at that moment to be so. How else can it happen? It's only in Western culture that we have this idea of the lawful cosmos. So in science, we have not only the idea the universe is rational, the universe is lawful, but here's a third idea. The rationality of the world out there is somehow mirrored in the rationality of our own minds. Now, if you think about this for a second, it's the strangest fact of all, because your brain is made up of atoms and molecules and neurons and circuits. So why should the whirring and churning that's going on in here somehow correspond or match up to the operations or the rationality of the world out there? Why should there be a one-to-one correspondence between the two? What is the reason? Well, there is no reason. If you're a Christian, you can say, well, all these things make a lot of sense to me. I believe God is omniscient, which is to say super rational, so he made a rational universe. God is a lawgiver. He gave us the Ten Commandments, the moral law, so we're not too surprised he gave us the laws of nature, the physical laws also. And we believe we are created in the image of God, so we have in us a spark of the divine rationality, so, hey, we're not too surprised that we are able to apprehend or comprehend the rationality of the world out there. But my point is, if you're an atheist, what is the basis for any of these assumptions? You have to take them 100% on faith. Now,